Hey, good. I'm not doing this to make anybody feel bad, but I'm just saying the ladies, the soprano and alto are basically, their song 23 is ready for the show. I mean, they're just singing, it's beautiful. It's just beautiful.
We recorded it.
Good. When do you have the choreography? Song of Thanksgiving, please, at the beginning. Solo auditions, Tuesday and the following Tuesday. Okay, let's see how we do with accompaniment, starting middle of page 5, 2 bars before 2. Oh, and maybe you saw, I hope a lot of you have already numbered your score. If you are, I screwed up. And I went from bar 191 at the bottom of page 17 to bar 193 at the top of top of 18. How many people is that going to destroy? No, I've just screwed up. So, if you would just mark those right now with Brian screwed up, then you'll know, oh, that's right. And you should end up with, Mary and I both ended up with 330. At the end. There was something else. Wasn't there something else in that email?
Yeah.
This piece?
Yes, it was the semi-chorus thing.
The semi-chorus thing. I was confusing. So let's clarify that, and that's on page 23, 24. 23, bottom, that's soprano 2 only. Soprano 2 only. And at top of 24 in the last bar, then it goes to soprano 1 only. And then at the bottom of 24 in the second bar with man strength, then it is the second soprano's joint. Sorry that I was contradictory.
You are forgiven, my son.
Take that for Bible now. Gospel. Okay, we are in bar 29, 2 before 20. 2 before 2 on page 5. Take it easy volume-wise. Rhythm, pitch.
Down.
have only those people. This is second basses, alto, or basses, altos, and first sopranos. But we're going to start in the second row, and to be praised. Can you shorten, can you drop the dot on the D? One more time, those same voices. Sing the dotted eight as though it was a 16th. Very short. Same voices. 2 and 3. Good. Add the other voices. And you sing your eighth notes just fine. Would you please mark that and do it that way? I know it's not the way you would sing it soloistically, but it will help clarify a muddy thing. Everybody, and then we're gonna go on. 2, 3. Let's just do the same spot. But those of you, second tenors and tenors, by second sopranos and tenors, your even eighth notes, where we have those that dotted rhythm that we cleaned up in the other parts, can you really sing those eighths very strongly, very evenly for me? Bottom of five, second bar, a cappella, and now we go on. 2, 3. Bottom of seven. It's very simple, but because it's, you know, the nature of the text, it's so...
confusing.
It's so affirmative. It's so, you know, such heartfelt praise, you know, complete faith. It has to just be solid, like a rock, rhythmically. Okay, bottom of the page is 58. Two, three. So here are your pitches at the bottom of seven, first bar. Two, three. I didn't hear the eighth note tenors, the tenor eighth notes on the first note. We're bottom of seven, first measure, tenors, I need to hear your eighth notes. Two, three.
Right. If you want to.
And we're not passing out scores at the concert. Is there another question or comment? Let's give it one more shot, page 8, and we go on. Okay? Very quiet.
2, 3.
Square on beat 3. Let's take that whole section faster. Okay, can we start at the bottom of nine and let's try this tempo?
One, two, three, four, and one.
it's short. Four. I guess the word for that would be aphoristic. Aphoristic. Look up aphorism when you go home. Let me do that again. Could you be sure and give us the triplet at the bottom of page 13? We really need that. One more time, and we're going to go on. We're going to turn the page. And bar before seven. One. And go one.
Cast on, cast on.
the desolations of the many generations. Five minutes. And then simple gifts.
have your biggest cheer. That is most certainly true. How many times do you think, just a random sort of maybe not important question, how many times did you breathe in that last G major chord? Only twice? Oh my gosh, I would breathe constantly. Only once? That's impressive. Just make sure that however many times you're breathing or needing to breathe, that you're always singing with good supported sound, good solid tone. I tell my kids it's never good to drive your car when it's on E, and the seniors laugh at me, but it's also never good to sing with that little air left. Just breathe and come back in. There's enough of us that we can cover that sound.
Make sure you sneak out and sneak in.
Yeah. I would hope that's implausible.
In our recording.
Can you hear it?
There's one voice going, ah, ah.
Yeah, that was it. That was tempo. Can we, from our seats, just run this whole thing? And I'm going to keep this in my ear.
Sure.
Do you mind playing it? It's gorgeous. It's gorgeous. Do you want to do it for a chair? The whole chair? Yeah. Let's agree on our key. Listen, the amount of clunkers I've had today. And it is. It's mezzo piano. It's bright. We gotta save something for the end. Very correct. Yeah. have no idea how to dance. This is how I think dancers move. I've lost all shame since I started teaching junior high. I'll tell you what, I'll do whatever to get them to sing. Just about. Okay. Can we look at what we did on Tuesday, please? This is the special chorus. Page 4. And I would like to do exactly what we did on Tuesday. Okay? So, starting with the sopranos, everybody else is pat, 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 pat. Emphasis on the clap, not the pat. Was that a question or were you just patting? Okay, great. Sopranos. I don't even know where A flat is anymore because we finished so hard in G. Can we start the pat claps on their loo? Not ahead of time, on loo. Where it's written in the music. Sort of. Here goes, sopranos. And one and two.
Hallelujah.
Yeah. So tenors and basses, you're the only ones pat clapping now. Adding altos. Yes, and one and two. All right, that was a valiant effort. Sopranos, I'm going to ask you to stop and pat clap, just the altos. Don't rush the pat claps either. This is gospel. There ain't nothing quick about this. Yes. And one and two. Hallelujah. 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 The storm. And yes, Alex, you fixed that one note that we talked about. That it was beautiful. You're pat clapping. You're pat clapping. Tenors. I used to take so much issue with this. The one note tenors, your G, I used to feel that it should be an F rather than a G. Because so much throughout this piece, we're dealing with the one chord and the two chords. So an A flat major chord and a B flat minor chord. Those two. Can you just play those kind of... Can I jump in here? Sorry. This is what my brain hears, is these two chords moving up. Those two chords are like the foundation of what we're doing here. But tenors, when you sing the G, we're making a completely new and different chord. Sing the G, it's what's written, it's not a mistake. I just needed to tell you that I might sing it wrong sometimes. I'm not going to sing it. Here you are.
I do.
I read what I think it should be.
Does it have a happy ending?
Always. Tim.
Is yours always better?
No. It took me 30 years to figure that out. Here's the C again. Thank you so much. Here we are, tenors. Everybody else, pat clapping, and one and two. Good. If you can look vertically, if you're able to read open score, those guess what two chords those are? A flat major and B flat minor. So that G just came out of nowhere. But you're doing it. Keep it really bright, really forward, especially if you're flipping it.
Hallelujah!
Nice and bright, please. Can we have basses? You don't need this, right? Okay. Although I will remind you of the one mistake that we did have on this, was moving to the next whole note a fraction of a beat early, because everybody else is moving on the end of 4. We gotta be so solid. 1, 2. Lay, loo, no rushing through there, please. All four parts. Let's see what happens. Let it fall apart.
Stop moving.
Yes.
It'll help you feel those beats.
Yes, it will. Yes, it will.
I'm just noticing that I think on the top of five in the last measure, some people are still syncopating now. Storm is.
Yes.
Even
quarter notes, not marcato tenuto. The storm is passing over.
I think it's the same, but a little bit longer, I guess.
Okay, I'll listen for that. Thank you. Yes. If you are looking for a solid, like, top recording of this piece, go to YouTube and look at the Detroit Mass Choir singing this piece. Detroit Mass Choir. Mass. M-A-S-S.
Would you mind sending that link
to my app? I've got it liked and favorited in my YouTube playlist I have for years. They are fantastic. It helps you find the group, and they are ad-libbing form. Entire forms. They're moving the repeats, and I'm going to do that to you on Tuesday, just so you know. Don't worry about it. You're going to be fine. This song has two chords, okay? Two is not difficult, so we can throw some wrenches. You'll be all right. Here we are, from the beginning, please. Have courage, my soul, and let us journey on. Everybody, please. Right where they come in. A flat major.
The kids will sing both simple groups and storm and festival groups.
How many rehearsals do we have with the kids? Because that will determine how many wrenches I throw into this.
Well, what we should do, I will email. And there will be a Sunday rehearsal, and that she helps me to come to, and so you should come to that too.
Okay.
And they'll sing the song 23 with the ladies, and the guys will sing Elvia Child of Peace.
Yes, good, good. If they're here, let's use them. I love it. I'm just telling you right now, the wrench I'm going to throw at you is taking a repeat sign. I'd rather it be 4 bars, it's going to be like 16 bars. That's all it is. And if you listen to the Detroit Mass Choir, it's how they do it, and it's very effective, and it kicks butt. Here we are. Have courage. Nice and easy now. And one. Have courage, my soul.
The storm is passing over.
There we go.
Thank you all so much. I really appreciate it. Thank you again to Debbie and the whole crew and Brian.
I'm